you've got there on your phone.
Ten o'clock by my watch, Mr. Chairman.
I have ten after by mine. One after.
We're running slow, but we either work slow.
No, it's not.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay, you're on the record.
If Forsyth County Civil Service Board will not come to order for the business before it is in the regular business meeting. Today is Thursday, November 10, 2011, at 10 o'clock a.m. Meeting in the small conference room of the Public Safety Conference on the Department. Sitting down. We're meeting in the conference room of the Public Safety Conference. And we're on 3527 Dan Road. Come and join. May I have a motion for it to accept the agenda?
I'll make a motion that the agenda be adopted as written. I second that.
Now, we should recognize all our people here.
All in favor.
Favor?
All in favor.
I beg your pardon. All in favor?
Aye.
Anything else? Business three. Mr. John Blanchard here is our member of the board. Mr. Terry Smith, Vice Chairman. Avery Howe, Chairman. Mr. Dana Miles, Hearing Officer. Ms. Charity Clark, Clerk for the Board. And Ms. Alessa Lorenzi.
Lorenzi?
With?
Forsyth County News.
County News, right. And we have others. Bonnie Jones, Attorney for Mr. Cranford.
That's correct.
They're here. We was going to have to set a hearing date for them. And see, Mr. Chester?
Kumarski.
Kumarski. Now, who left that?
Just Mr. Cranford and Ms. Tisdale.
Well, she can't, he recognized Mr. Bonnie and his, or Mr. Cranford.
Yeah, I have got everybody down.
Ms. Tisdale.
Yeah. Welcome, Ms. Tisdale.
Thank you, sir.
What are we looking at, buddy? All right, gentlemen. The adoption of the minutes for Thursday, October 13th, regular meeting, and also for Thursday, October 20th, called executive session.
Mr. Chairman, we'll need two different motions on that since it was two different meetings.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we adopt the minutes of the Thursday, October the 13th, 2011 meeting as written.
I second that.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried unanimously.
And I also make a motion that we adopt the minutes of our special called meeting on October the 20th, 2011.
I second that.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
That's unanimous.
What a surprise.
I've run out of ink before. Okay. All right, and the whole business?
Okay, the civil service legislation, just to update the Civil Service Board, on November 3rd, 2011, at the Board of Commissioners regular meeting, they approved a modification to the Civil Service Board local legislation, and this requires two consecutive votes at two meetings, so it will be on the November 17th, 2011 meeting of the Board of Commissioners for consideration at that time as well.
Thank you so very much. Mr. Hearing Officer?
No new report on the John Gooch writ of cert. It's still pending in front of the Superior Court.
All right.
And I believe the next matter is mine too as well.
Yes, it is.
Mr.
Yes,
Chairman, at your request or the board's request, I have drafted proposed decision on the Jeff Chance for the board's consideration and vote this morning.
Mr. Chairman, I think that we both all had a matter to review this and for final approval, and therefore I make a motion that we approve the decision that was reached on the Jeff Chance case remand as written by our hearing officer, and that you be authorized to execute such upon approval of this motion.
I second that.
All in favor of the motion, aye.
Aye.
Yes.
Mr. Chairman, I present to you the original of that. I'd ask that you execute that and then you give it to our clerk so she can attest your signature. I would recommend that the clerk keep the original, and I've bought several additional copies in case members of the public or others are interested.
Mr. Chairman, if it'd be appropriate this time, I'd like to commend our hearing officer for the outstanding job that he did in drafting our decision. I think it explains everything to the T and leaves little doubt that can be disputed from our end.
I second that. Very well put.
I second it too. I think the judge was very nice in commending our hearing officer. I think he's be thankful and proud for you. Reading all that legal stuff is kind of like me reading the Bible in the Greek edition. Somebody don't put all this terminology, turn it up to me. Thanks a lot, I appreciate that. Next thing, this call brings up the date on hearing Mr. Jim Cranford.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Cranford and his attorney are present today. The board is to set a date for his appeal hearing for termination from the Forsyth County Fire Department. His appeal was received by me on behalf of the board on October 13th. According to our revised civil service policy, all formal appeals must be heard within 120 days of the appeal. So the drop dead date, so to speak, or the last date would be February 10th. That the latest that the board could hear this.
Mr. Chairman, if I might add, I've got a conflict on a regular meeting date in December, which I believe is December the 8th.
Yes, sir.
If it would please the board, I would suggest that everybody look at their schedule. If we could put a regular meeting off until December the 15th, 1 week later, you'll be gone. Kill that.
and do the Cranford appeal at the same time?
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Try Christmas Day.
Do it Christmas Day.
That'll be on a Sunday.
True. So we would like for it to be heard before the end of the year, but all possible schedules to know.
When will you be out of town for, Mr. Blanchard?
I'm going back to Indiana to visit the children.
What day?
On what day?
Oh, from 9th through the 16th.
Okay. How does the 22nd and 23rd look?
Thursday and Friday. I'm open.
I guess one of the questions we would have, Ms. Jones, how long do you anticipate this hearing will take?
We would, 2 hours probably.
2 hours?
Correct.
Okay, so I think we should allocate 2 days in light of how typical attorney estimates of time go in the civil service board.
Usually
with all due respect.
It's the other side that runs over.
I'm not directing that just at you.
I direct that at
the attorneys in general and the county attorney as well as whoever the appellant's attorney is.
We say that to everybody.
Yes, we do. If we can do it in one day, that would be a blessing.
It would be.
But we try to allocate extra time just in case.
We would probably need about 2 hours, barring questions.
Would y'all be available on that date of the 22nd?
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Chairman.
Wait, just a minute. What day is that?
The 22nd is
a Thursday.
Thursday. Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we change our regular meeting date from December the 8th until December the 22nd, and on that date that we have the hearing for Mr. Cranford. And that we'd also have our business meeting that day. Okay. We begin at 9:30.
With the business meeting first, followed by the appeal.
That suits everybody.
That's fine. Thank you very much.
Okay.
I would, before you vote, Mr. Chairman, I would respectfully request that members of the board reserve the 23rd. While I respect what Ms. Jones has said, and I hope we can do it in one day, I know the board likes to do things continuously if we can, rather than breaking it up by having time in between. So if y'all will reserve the 23rd just in case, because the county is not here to tell us how long they think their side of the case is going to take.
That's fine.
So in fairness to them, I would just ask for that.
Okay. All right. Motion, please.
Second.
And he seconded it already. It's 12, 22nd, 11th. Regular meeting and the hearing, is that correct?
Yes.
All in favor of that motion, say aye. Aye. Okay,
we'll start that at 9:30. Ms. Jones, for your information, typically the regular meeting will take 5 to 10 minutes, and then we'll be starting into your appeal.
We'll be ready at 9:30.
And Dr. Howell will turn the meeting over to me at that point in time, and I'll conduct the appeal.
Thank
just sort of procedure, that's what happens.
All right, is there anything else to come up on new business? Mr. Blanchard, you did get your letter now from the commission.
Yes, I did.
You're
yes,
officially a member of the board, right?
Yes.
We're glad to hear that. This is the second or third term. How many times have you been served there, Mr. Blanchard?
At least three.
This is
at least three. Starting on your third. You've served two of your
starting on third.
Okay.
And I'll send the updated for the terms. I'll send that out electronically to you all. I know you'd like to keep a copy of that. So I've updated that for the Board of Commissioners clerk. So I will send that to you all.
Congratulations, Mr. Blanchard.
Thank you.
Anything else to bring up?
No other appeals have been received, sir.
Mr. Smith, anything?
No. I make a motion to adjourn.
I second that.
All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
We stand adjourned until December 22nd.
Yeah. I assume that we'll take proper, well, do we have to notify the attorneys of our decision or just the judge?
I did.
Okay.
This morning right before I came over here.
So, okay.
Outstanding.
And then we'll need to forward that to the judge.
Okay, so
he gets the original.
The original. I need to
make
go
a
ahead
copy as signed.
And file it with the clerk.
Right. I have some additional copies if anybody wants one.